It's all about this anomaly, it seems like. Cronus. Okay.
Jack! Jack! It's okay. It's me. It's Liv.
Liv?
Jack! You're alright.
What? They're like word parallels.
Liv, something's happened. I'm not entirely sure how to describe it.
I pulled your memory archive while you were out. Your logs are flooded with all this bizarre data. Delta Squad, bio-torpedoes, something called the Ithaca.
Mm-hmm.
Jack, what is all this? What's going on?
Liv, I saw the Kronos. I saw our old station.
Come again?
I was on a ship, a shuttle. There were other Echo units, a military detachment sent to investigate what happened to the Kronos.
Okay. Maybe you're not so alright after all.
You're a little drunny person that
called that one a little too early.
Should believe me.
It's not a malfunction. I was there. I was home.
Okay. I believe you. Listen, there's something you need to know. While you were out, I had a chance to meet with the captain of this ship.
The man we heard over the comms?
His name is Dr. Harlan. He said... He told me...
Liv, what is it? What's wrong?
You know what? It's probably better if you just see it for yourself. We can get a closer look at your memory archive while we're at it.
Is it that bad?
Come on, follow me. Listen, this Dr. Harlan isn't what you might call the cheeriest of souls. He might take some getting used to. Juno, I have Jack. Can you let us up?
I did warn you the station's generator was temperamental.
How much longer can we operate on emergency power?
Maintaining our current energy draw? A few hours.
A few hours?
Dr. Harlan?
Jack, you finally recovered. I was beginning to think the blast from the FTL had obliterated your neural matrix.
So,
you'd be happy, huh?
The android, the Echo unit.
Hey, I'm here. Hello? Is that Morgan Freeman?
Jack, this is Dr. Harlan. My administrator.
Hold my hand.
What exactly are you doing here, Doctor?
Odd question coming from you.
Hey.
Dr. Harlan is a geneticist, specializing in the biomass.
You're here to study the biomass?
I'm here to try and find a way to destroy it.
He's also the one responsible for our extended stay in the HAB.
That was for your own safety. I would think that would be painfully obvious by now.
Dr. Harlan, I need you to show Jack what you showed me.
I have work to do. He's your android. You explain it to him.
He needs to see it.
Captain, perhaps I can be of some assistance.
Okay, that's specific personality, that's for sure.
Are you certain you want to see this again, Captain?
Just pull it up.
Come on.
Very well.
Can't be that bad.
What exactly am I looking at?
The future. All this orange you're seeing on the map? That's all biomass. That's how far it's spread.
To date, the infection has consumed approximately 56% of the habitable solar system.
Including Earth.
How did all this happen?
It starts with us.
With us?
With the destruction of the Kronos.
Really?
7 October, 2126. Your station, the Kronos 2, is almost completely destroyed when an unknown vessel suddenly appears in your sector.
The Astraea.
Correct.
When the Astraea traveled back to our time, it brought the biomass with it. And when we left...
The infection stayed behind.
Are we starting to see where this is going? I'm confused.
In the days following the incident, a fleet of Atlas survey ships unknowingly passed through the infected zone. Most of the fleet's crew complement is consumed by the biomass. The infected fleet proceeds along its predetermined course toward Earth. One by one, the now crippled vessels collide with the planet's surface, unleashing a global infestation. Humanity has no defense.
Billions of people, most of the planet, just gone.
I mean, we were escaping the threat.
The remnants of humankind are scattered across the solar system. But without any means to combat the spread of the biomass...
It's only a matter of time. All those people.
In truth, the initial death toll would likely have been higher had it not been for the captain of the Ithaca, who managed
to... The Ithaca?
The Ithaca was the flagship of the returning fleet.
Ithaca? I've seen that name before.
Hardly surprising. The Ithaca...
I remember it as well. I heard it. When I was in the past.
When you were what?
Ah, that's it! That's where I saw it. In your memory logs.
Hmm?
I've got the data right here. Look. Jack, would you mind running us through what we're seeing here?
I recall overhearing the ship was expected to arrive in Saturn orbit within a few days.
I don't understand. For that to be true, these logs would have to be from 2126. A full 3 months before the Ithaca crashed on Earth.
That is correct.
Jack, are you suggesting that you traveled back in time?
I know how it sounds.
I'm not sure you do.
This is why your memory was so fragmented. In the control room. Because you... You went back in time.
Not physically. Just my data. My consciousness.
Oh.
I believe the FTL accident may have briefly opened another temporal anomaly, disabling my shell and forcing my protocols to transfer to another Echo unit.
400 years in the past.
Evidently.
You believe Jack's account, Captain?
It makes sense. A botched FTL jump is the whole reason we're in this mess to begin with.
It's the only explanation.
That is difficult to dispute.
Yes!
Juno, you with us?
Oh. Apologies, Captain. I was distracted.
Something wrong?
I'm not sure. Can we access this memory block?
Just a sec.
Just as I thought.
What are we looking at here?
Yeah, I wasn't sure either.
Some form of weapon I encountered while in the past.
Dr. Harlan.
As I recall, they're fitted with a form of biomass payload.
Oh, lovely.
Dr. Harlan.
Still, not now.
Dr. Harlan, you should really take a look at this.
What part of not now do you not understand?
What? What is it?
The torpedo appears to be undetonated.
What's that supposed to mean?
Where did you pull this image from?
This is from one of Jack's recent memory logs.
Recent memory logs?
It's difficult to explain. It may or may not involve time travel.
I'm sorry, what?
We can parse out the details later. Right now, Doctor, you do realize what this could mean.
A solution.
Solution to what? Will someone please tell me what the hell's going on?
Right. Come with me.
There have been weirder things going on, okay? Time travel is... not weird at all.
You're studying these weapons, these bio-torpedoes.
They're not weapons so much as incubators. Inside each one is a sampling of a biomass-based genetic material. The infection in its purest form. All you need to know is this. If I could manage to sequence this material, I am confident I could develop a means to eliminate biomass.
You're saying a cure?
It's what I've been searching for. But every torpedo I've encountered has been detonated. I've never seen one with its payload still intact.
So do you mean we have to go back in time to retrieve the data?
But I have.
If that's true, then you may have just found the key to saving what's left of humanity.
Dr. Harmon, I'm afraid we may have more pressing matters.
Do you know the red? Energy reserves are dipping into the red. I suggest we table this conversation until we find a way to restore the station's generator.
Perhaps there's something we can do.
Dr. Harlan, this is the part where you ask us for help.
How do we fix the generator?
Fixing the generator isn't the problem. The problem is getting to it. The generator facility is not accessible from within the station. You need to approach from the exterior. Search the outer hull for a way inside.
With a few improvements, you should have no trouble at all.
Does it mean I get my boosters finally?
Exactly what sort of improvements do you have in mind?
Nothing drastic. Just an entirely new shell.
I'm sorry?
Well, you can't go venturing out to the generator in that old relic. No offense intended, of course.
Of course.
Is this really necessary?
Transferring Jack to a newer shell will allow him to more easily interface with the station's various systems, as well as drastically improve his ability to maneuver in open space.
Hell yeah.
Not to mention...
All right. Fine. So long as there's not too much of a strain on our power reserves.
This way, Jack.
Yay! Upgrades! About damn time.
I have already identified a shell design I believe you'll find satisfactory. It was originally meant for rapid emergency response. The base
hey.
Design includes enhanced speed and durability, as well as a data link
she blocked me.
To the station's architecture.
Well,
I've already uploaded the shell's blueprints. It'll only take a moment to complete fabrication.
This looks familiar.
I've already adjusted the shell's underlying design to account for the particulars of Jack's neural matrix. All you'll need to do is shut yourself down so I can transfer your processes to the new shell.
Oh, that's all, is it?
Don't worry, Captain. The transfer will be seamless.
Well, we can trust her now, I guess.
Construction complete. The new shell is prepped for transfer.
Ooh.
It looks like him.
Yes, I incorporated Jack's existing facial structure into the shell's design. I thought it might help distinguish him.
He is quite distinguished.
Jack, you're clear to initiate the shutdown procedure whenever you're ready.